welcome to my parents and the host of the Jim Bakker Show, Jim and Lori Bakker.
And I want to welcome all of our beautiful audience to the studio audience today. Thank you, everybody, for being here on Great Street.
Yes.
We have a great show lined up for you.
You don't want to miss it.
One of America's great pastors, Paul Begley, is here.
Woo! We are excited.
Fourth generation preacher ordained by my old friend, Dr. Lester Summerall.
Yeah. Wow.
My land. He's been gone for quite a while.
I know. I was one of the last ones to get in. I think 6 weeks before he died is when he laid his hands on
me. You're kidding.
Wow. That's really
You're a young guy. You're only in your 50s, so you've been ministering for 37 years since you were a teenager, right?
Right. Yeah.
That's awesome.
Wow.
Yeah.
So. Wow, we're glad to have you here. He's known for his gifting in evangelization and Bible prophecy. His program is Coming Apocalypse is the name of it. It's on the PTO Voice of the Prophets Network.
Yes, it is.
Praise God.
Yes, it
Everybody
is.
Everybody who's anybody is on that network now. The network is growing and growing and growing, dozens and dozens of new programs coming the last month or so.
That's right.
Wow.
And it is just going to be sold out. It's literally going to be full. And then with the new shopping network,
right,
which is on that stage, it's faith-based. Mm-hmm. But it pays the bills for all the Christian television. I've been thinking about this for like 50 years.
Right. No joke. Tammy Sue actually has the original paperwork from 1986, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes, that's right.
You have them in the hidden vault.
And I do.
Anyway, but she really does. I've seen them.
I showed them to you.
You did. And
well, one of the last things
I did. In 1986, right, you had this idea.
We had the shopping network there.
Right, to do a faith-based home
shopping
network.
And when we lost everything, we had the conveyor bills. We had.
That's in 1986. That was way before, you know, the other shopping
network. Bob and Jeannie Johnson were going to be part of the host there. They were going to be singing, and it was going to be a singing show as well. So,
I was still going to be singing.
It's still going to be singing.
Tammy Sue Bakker.
That's right.
And they've asked me to host once in a while, so I am going to introduce some new
I want you to co-host with me one day, Dad.
Oh, wouldn't that be? Oh, that would be great.
Do I get to preach a little bit?
Yes, I'll let you preach. Yeah.
That'll be great.
You know, the Christian bookstores, so many of them, thousands of them have closed.
That's right.
And it's so we're opening up a big shopping network.
And you got to get into deals, and the more you shop, the more you support the network.
Right. You know, it's funny.
This is
Derek Gilbert.
And Sharon Gilbert here with us.
I don't often talk about this, but back in 1986, when I was on the air on radio in Philadelphia, just as a kind of a gag, I answered an ad for an audition for a new television network that was starting, and they actually offered me the job. It turned out it was one of the big shopping networks, the secular shopping networks.
It was QVC.
Yeah, of course.
And I asked them. I said, "Well, can I stay on the air? Because you know I don't want to give up my radio job." They said, "No, you'll have to quit." Like, okay, well, no, I'm a radio guy, so I could have been one of the original hosts on QVC, but I turned it down because.
Well,
now here we are.
You know what?
Well,
guess
if you get
what,
more
Derek,
we have
work,
a job
you can
for
work
you.
Fulfill
we need
your
you
dreams,
to come
come
on
true.
Over to the shop at Once in a While Studio C and come on over.
Love it. That's great.
Wow, you
Do
guys are growing and growing, and of course you have your own network.
Skywatch TV.
Well, Skywatch TV is a studio that we produce a lot of content, a lot of content. In fact, you know, Sci Friday's been on the PTO network for a long time.
Yes.
And, of course, Unraveling Revelation is on there. And we've got a brand new show that's getting ready to air on there called The Bible's Greatest Mystery.
That's exciting.
Great. We're thrilled to have you here today. You're our dear friends.
Them.
You're more like family than, than guests.
They really are.
You've been around here so much, and we just love you so much.
Mm-hmm.
And your friend Paul Begley is here. He is your friend.
Mm-hmm.
And you,
and
how long you guys
friend.
Have been friends?
I know he long should time. Be your friend.
He is now.
I am your friend now.
Good to have you here with us.
We met Paul for the first time at a conference that was organized by our friends Mike Kerr and Jeannie Moore.
Right.
Their ministry is called Hear the Watchmen, and this was back in about 4 or 5 years ago. About 5 years ago, I think.
Yeah. At least five, yeah.
And so we first saw Paul speak and preach at one of these conferences, and we probably do, you know, up to COVID, we were doing five or six of these a year, and Paul would often be at the same conference, and boy, he is
anointed.
Yeah.
You know, the anointing is so powerful once it gets in anyone's life. And the more we allow God to have his way in our life, you know, it's unlimited what God will do.
So true.
You know, it's unlimited.
It really
is. What you least expect is probably what God will have you do.
Isn't that the
Come on,
truth?
Moses, get off the backside and go get them, right?
Oh, boy. He's going to preach.
If you go to our internet, you're going to be able to see where our programs are.
Absolutely.
On the Voice of the Prophet.
Absolutely. So you can go to PTL Network, and there is an icon there that shows the shows, the channel listings, the schedules, and anything that is airing live on the PTL Network. You can find it on ptlnetwork.com, or you can download the app on your phone on the go. This is the best way to watch the PTL Network.
And your show's called The Coming Apocalypse.
Absolutely, because it's coming.
It is coming.
It is coming.
See, honey?
And I just read on the internet that this is the safest place in the world for the apocalypse. So I'm glad I'm here.
It is.
It is.
Yeah, you come to the mountain for the
I know
right
it.
Time.
Well, I think right here at right at this location is probably the safest.
Wow.
Because
and
the presence of
pick
God.
It. You know, Corrie ten Boom was flying over this area years and years ago.
Oh, yeah.
And she looked down, and God said, there's going to be a great move of God come from right down there.
Wow.
And it was here flying above the Ozarks. And she told the pilot to land, and he said, oh, there's no airport. They can't land. She said, land. God says there's an airport. And so he looks over in his charts and finds a dirt field, which I think probably from the college, you know.
Mm-hmm. College of the Ozarks,
go. Yes. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And so he landed, and that prophecy's been told over and over again now.
Mm-hmm.
And God has fulfilled it. And you guys are, how far from us are you? A few miles, aren't you?
We're about an hour. I mean, as the crow flies, it may be 25 miles. But the crows don't fly, you know, the highways that we have to take.
that's the truth. When you come to the Ozarks, it's windy hills.
So here they have this great network now, just down the road from us, up here in these hills. And then Billy Brim is just across the valley the other direction, you know, and she has Prayer Mountain up here in these hills.
Yes.
And she's doing an amazing job.
Wow.
In fact, her granddaughter, right? Hannah Brim has a TV show on our network.
Her granddaughter, yes. She's young, and she has so much to say for such wisdom for such a young woman of God.
God's doing great things.
Yes. Amen.
Paul, it's so great to have you with us today. And I understand that Dr. Irvin Baxter was a spiritual mentor to you.
He really is. And when first time I met him down in Dallas, and he, you know, he's one of the he was absolutely one of the nicest people I ever met.
That is
him
so
and his
true.
Wife are wonderful people.
Absolutely.
Spent a lot of hours in his office studying the Word of God, digging deep in the Revelation, debating a little bit.
But your dad's still preaching?
My dad's 85. He's still fire. He's on fire.
I love it.
He's preaching hard.
Praise
and you go,
God.
Do you preach in his church?
I do. As a matter of fact, this Sunday I'm going to be getting back there in time to preach. Yes. About 6 or 7 times a year. I'm preaching in Dad's
church. I hate to bring this up, but you had a stroke.
I did.
And we're sort of like stroke brothers.
We are stroke brothers.
You know, and that you're too young to have a stroke.
Yeah.
And you're back.
Back. It's a miracle, Jim, just like you. My stroke was 3 months before yours, and I was on the air doing a live internet broadcast.
Ooh.
Live on the air when it hit me. And 4,000 or 5,000 people were watching on the channel at that moment. I didn't know where I was at. My wife come. My beautiful wife, Heidi, is here today.
Hi, Heidi.
Well, she's here.
So nice to have you here.
And
great.
I was downstairs in my studio. She came down and got me off the air, shut the program down.
They do that.
They save us.
Something about wives that save us from when we have our crisis moments.
And, but, yeah, I had a stroke. It affected my walking, my balance, my speech, my memory, you know. And I tell you, it's tough when you're used to going a million miles an hour like you, to when the doctor says, slow everything down and stop. You need to rest. How do you rest in an hour that we're in, Jim, right now, with so many people needing to be saved, and the world is really hungering for the word, but there's so many events going on around the world. It's hard to sit there and rest. But God's given us strength. He's healing us. He's healing Jim. I mean, praise God.
Yeah.
Amen. We're in it to win it, aren't we?
Yeah. Amen.
It's amazing.
Amen.
We're in it to win it.
You seem to be doing absolutely incredible. I mean, considering.
Yeah. It's really been remarkable. And I've went through some treatments down in the villages in Florida. First one in the world, hyperbaric chamber. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Hyperbaric.
Yes, a hyperbaric.
And where they put you in a submarine and then put all that pressure and you're breathing oxygen and you're doing specialized video games just for the areas of your brain that's injured.
Really?
Yes. I went in a diabetic. I came out. No more metformin for me.
Right.
Yeah.
Exactly. Wow. That's true.
And with all the prayers of the people, I had a cane. That got thrown away. and my balance is much better. My memory is getting much better.
Praise God.
But the anointing never leaves me. And this is the truth. When I'm preaching, and they got video of it, when I'm preaching, I can walk down, run. I can run and walk stairs. When I'm in the anointing, I come off, you know, I might need a little help.
Okay? Yeah, yeah.
So my wife says simply, stay in the anointing more often.
So does
your
it
program,
seem,
the
it
coming
seems up, like the, yeah. the enemy is trying to take out the big preachers. Mm-hmm. He thinks you're a threat.
He knows he's a threat.
He knows you're a threat.
Yeah,
he knows
yeah.
you're a threat.
Mm-hmm.
But Barry Stone's been going through a whole lot.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, there are a lot of important men and women who are targets right now.
Amen.
You need to pray for the preachers. You need to pray for the because there's warfare.
Pray for
and
your pastors.
And greater is he that's in us than the he's in the world.
Amen.
And we can stop this warfare, and the church is going to be triumphant. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen. And I really want to just quickly, I know that there are people out there right now, I know you're sitting out there, and you've probably thought, I've got a bank account, I've got a savings account, I've got investments, and I don't know what I'm going to do with it. Maybe I don't have plans to leave it to my family. Trust me. Remember how when Moses was standing on top of the hill, and he was told, as long as your arms are up, there will be victory?
Wow. Yes.
Yep.
Sometimes the man of God or the woman of God needs someone standing there to hold his or her arms up.
So true.
And if you can't be there personally, you can help financially.
Yes.
Amen. That's how we're going to make it. It's the whole church standing together. Forsake not the assembling of yourselves together. The more we see that day coming.
That's right.
We're to come together more. And that's going to be the key. The church of Jesus Christ is the key to survival of the body of Christ in the last days. Your program, The Coming Apocalypse, is on our network, and I have the trailer, we call them trailers, of that. So let's roll that now so people can get an idea about your show.
There's an hour coming when all in the grave are going to hear his voice and come forth. But there's two resurrections, the resurrection of life and the resurrection of damnation. When the resurrection comes, again, go to John chapter 5. Remember what the Lord said. The Bible says, John 5:28, marvel not at this, for the hour is coming in the which all that are in the graves shall hear his voice, and they shall come forth. They have done good unto the resurrection of life. That's why Jesus said in the word in Revelation, blessed are ye have part in the first resurrection, for the second death have no power over you. It's time for the final showdown, and that's exactly what's about to happen in the Bible. The Bible says every eye shall behold him, every knee's gonna bow, every tongue's gonna confess that he is the King of kings and the Lord of lords. He's the wonderful counselor, the almighty Almighty God, the Prince of Peace. He's the Rose of Sharon. He's the Lily of the Valley. He's the Bright in the Morning Star. He's the Bread of Heaven. He is the Door into the Sheepfold. I believe there will be massive earthquakes, huge tsunamis. The stars will be falling from heaven. The heavens will be rolled back like a scroll. The volcanoes will be erupting planet-wise. The poles will be shifting. Every unimaginable, the winds will be howling. The Bible says every island and every mountain will be moved out of its place. When this gospel of the kingdom is preached into all the world for a witness unto all nations, then shall the end come. We're in the last days, and this gospel is going to be preached into all the world. And God's going to use every avenue, television, radio, shortwave, internet, people on foot, churches, tent revivals. It don't matter. We're going to get it done. The Bible said that His word will go out where He sends it. It will not return void. Listen, folks, Matthew 24 is before us. If one angel can bring an earthquake that literally shakes Jerusalem, what will it be when all of the host of heaven leave glory with Jesus Christ? The clouds are full of angels. Can you imagine the power of the resurrection when that last trump is sounded and the dead in Christ rise? Are you serious? Are you serious? You better get ready. The Lord is coming back.
Praise
God. He's coming back.
Woo!
He's coming back.
You just keep preaching it.
Yeah, he's preaching it. Well, He is coming back, Jim.
Yeah.
I mean, He's coming back.
Right. Listen, I want everyone to, if you want to hear more of Paul Begley preaching, we have his CD here.
We have DVD and CD.
It's a DVD.
We have it's a combination
with a bonus
set.
CD in there.
Right, because...
So it has Isaiah's Apocalypse. Yes. What does that mean?
It means the revelation, okay, apocalypse. Isaiah literally gives an account of the coming apocalypse in the end. And it's very close to what Jesus says in Matthew 24 and on
into
Revelation.
That's what I've been hearing about what you're teaching.
A pole shift is in Isaiah 24. It says the earth's going to flip almost upside down.
Mm-hmm. That's true, people.
Real like a drunken man, to and fro. So Isaiah was the greatest prophet I think it ever was, Jim.
How did you get that?
Well, I was studying the book of Isaiah about, okay, he prophesied that a child shall be born.
I had to go to prison to get that.
Well, I'm sorry.
It's not fair.
Don't pray that on me.
That's right, exactly.
No, you are. You've been through enough. Now.
I've been through enough.
Jesus,
but
man.
Hey, well, you know, if people would spend time in the Bible, is what you're saying.
That's what it is.
You will find these mm-hmm. unbelievable mm-hmm. nuggets that are in the Word of God.
So true.
We're going to be in trouble. I can see that.
Yeah, you and I. Yeah.
You too. I knew when Jim connected with you, Pastor Paul, this was going to be it, right, everybody?
It's hard to find people that believe what I believe. I have a prison-tested theology.
That's good. That's good.
But I'll tell you what, I want you to order his video, mm-hmm. and it includes two DVD sets, Isaiah Apocalypse,
right,
and the Journey CD.
Yes.
What is this Journey CD?
Oh, now the Journey CD is my music CD.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. Whoa. Yeah.
Oh. Now see, how many know he sings? Do you know that? Is that why you're here?
Yeah, they're here to hear Pastor
Are you serious?
We have a crowd here today. They're here to hear you sing.
Yeah, I'm shocked by the crowd. It's a wonderful crowd.
It is a wonderful crowd.
Up here in the hills.
Oh, man.
You have to be coming here to come
you
here.
You got to seek this place out like the Bible.
You weren't passing by to come
no.
to.
No.
I want you to do a song. Let's get started. Then we're gonna, and then we're going to have you preach, and Derek and Sharon preach with you. And.
Yeah,
and,
it's great.
They're going to be back tomorrow, by the way, so we're just going to get started today, I have a feeling.
There is a fountain filled with blood drawn from Emmanuel's veins, and sinners plunge beneath that flood, loose all their guilty stains, loose all
dying thief. Rejoice to see that fountain in his day. And there may I, though vile as he, wash all my sins away. Wash all my sins away. Wash all my sins away. And there may I, though vile as he, wash all my sins away. Dear dying lamb, thy precious blood shall never, it'll never lose its power. Till all the ransomed church of God be saved to sin no more. Be saved to sin no more. Be saved to sin no more. Till all the ransomed church of God be saved to sin no more. There since by faith I saw that stream, thy flowing wounds apply. Redeeming love has been my theme and shall be till I die. And shall be till I die. And shall be till I die. Shall be till I die. There is a fountain filled with blood drawn from Emmanuel's veins.
Wow.
I remember that song.
Pastor Paul Begley.
Wow. Yes. I remember that song. I
don't know if
you
hear
me, but yeah, I'm going to tell you, Nazarene Church, I was born and raised. We sang that song.
Sang that one, didn't you?
Church.
Oh, yeah.
We sure did. I don't know about where you were born and raised. I don't know if you remember those songs.
We used to sing those songs all the time, but how many churches have stopped preaching the blood?
That's right.
I know. You're right, Sharon. And without the blood of Christ, we have nothing, okay? Nothing.
Too many years ago, many of the great old church groups took all the blood songs out of the Bible, out of the hymnal. They said, we don't want a bloody religion. But I'll tell you, we have a bloody religion.
That's right. That's right.
Without the blood.
That's right. And you know something? That's why in the CD, I wanted one or two hymnals in there. You know, there's a lot of other more modern songs and more newer songs, but I wanted to get a couple hymnals in there because we can't ever get away from our foundation.
Yes, right.
Of what saves us and sets us free.
What is the offer on that?
For a $30 donation to the ministry. You're going to receive 2-disc DVD teachings plus the bonus music CD, which includes 13 songs like Back to God, Dress Blues, Believe, Down to the River to Pray, Shelter Me, Lord. Amazing, amazing songs.
Ain't No Grave.
Going to hold my body down.
Oh, boy.
Should have sung that one. I don't know why I didn't. Oh, yeah. My grandmother used to sing that one. Okay.
Oh, yeah. Oh, man. Ain't No Grave. Going to hold me down.
But that's the thing. You're absolutely right. I was in my mid-30s before I ever heard a sermon preach on the blood of Jesus Christ.
Really? Wow.
I was raised in a church, very liturgical domination, and I don't want to, you know, slander anybody or say anything negative, but that's just so many of the churches today just want to make it very safe and comforting, and, you know, God loves us all no matter where we are and how we are. But that's not the nature of the war that we're in. This is a supernatural war.
Amen.
And without that blood, without that sacrifice that Jesus made on the cross, we're lost.
That's
the enemy doesn't care what we believe. They just don't want us believing that one thing that's true.
Amen.
Paul, you believe we're in Matthew 24, right?
Absolutely. Right in the middle of it.
Yeah.
If not throughout it. Certainly, Jim, you know, the Bible says it's the beginning of sorrows. Well, if you look at false Christ, false prophets shall rise. They'll deceive many. We'll hear of wars, rumors of wars. See that you're not troubled, for all these things must come to pass. The end is not yet, for nation shall rise against nation, kingdom against kingdom, famines, pestilence, earthquakes. You know, it's all there. And then persecution of the church. That's the next verse. I used to say, well, we're in Matthew 24:8, and all these are the beginning of sorrows. But now I say we're in verse 9. Then shall they deliver you up to be afflicted and shall kill you, and you'll be hated of all nations.
We are.
But for my name's sake.
Right.
So I just want to say that, Jim, Lori, having a network where truly the focus is telling people it's time to get to Jesus. Mm-hmm. And it's the last days. Let's hear the voice of the prophet.
Right. Amen.
This is such a prophetic network.
Amen.
I was telling our producer, Bob Poplin, I said, I'm so thankful that we are on this network, because we've got to get this message out.
Right.
We're in the middle of Matthew 24. And look, we just went through this pandemic.
Yeah.
They tried to lock us down, shut
That's
us
right.
down. They shut my dad's church down 2 weeks. He called me on the phone and said, Paul, I don't care if they bring the National Guard. I will never close this church again. Never.
Oh, man. So, you got to give him some love.
We got to fight for what's right.
Yeah.
We do.
You're so right. Derek, you believe the four horsemen of the apocalypse are riding now. Now, I came out of prison preaching the four horses were riding, because, and people, I guess, all thought I was crazy. So you actually think there are riding? You believe what I preach?
Right. Well, we look not only at the news headlines and see what's going on around the world, but when you look at the first century and what the apostles believed, we see that Stephen, when he was being stoned, and of course, Saul of Tarsus, Paul was there holding the cloaks of those who were murdering Stephen. He looked up and saw the Son of Man at the right hand of God. So Jesus was at the right hand of God then. Now, in Revelation, we see that John is...
He's weeping.
Weeping, because no one is found in heaven, on the earth, or under the earth, which is interesting.
Which leads to the question, where was Jesus at that second?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Why was John weeping? Because Jesus wasn't there.
Mm. Wow.
John was taken back into the past, to the moment between the crucifixion, mm-hmm. that time between the crucifixion and the mm-hmm. resurrection, because suddenly the Lamb who was slain appears mm-hmm. between the four creatures mm-hmm. and the Ancient of Days, and he's given the scroll. It doesn't make sense that here we are 2,000 years later and nobody knows where Jesus is yet, and we're still waiting for him to show up in heaven to open the scroll.
Exactly.
So because it happened then.
Exactly. He starts opening those seals right away.
Yep.
Those first four seals, five seals.
Broke them.
Have been broken.
Yes, they have. Mm-hmm.
And we've been watching those riders for 2,000 years mm-hmm. go through the earth and just
yes.
ruin it mm-hmm. over and over and over again. And they are warring against who? Against the Lord.
Amen.
And his church. And that's why we are in, you know, birth pangs?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
You ever had birth pangs?
Mm-hmm. Definitely.
Well, I've never had a child. But I've certainly read about it. How many of you ladies have had a baby? It gets easier toward the end, right?
That last trimester, that even makes you and I nervous. Okay.
But we're toward the end. Praise God, the baby's almost here.
Amen, amen.
Right. They really are.
Wow. Paul, did Isaiah prophesy about the apocalypse in chapter 24?
He did. Jim, he did. Even the very first verse, he said, behold, the Lord maketh the earth empty, maketh it waste, turneth it upside down, and scattereth abroad the inhabitants. He goes on to say that the world's going to mourn. It's going to languish. And because also the earth's going to reel and rock like a drunkard. So, and then he even tells us why. Because of the transgression of sin. Because they broke the holy covenant of God. So Isaiah could see the end time apocalypse. He was the first prophet to say a child shall be born, a virgin shall conceive. He's the prophet that told us that Satan would be cast out of heaven in Isaiah 14. He's the prophet that says God's going to kill Leviathan, the old serpent, the old Ooh. Dragon in Revelation.
Wow. Yes.
He's the prophet that said, in Isaiah 53, but by his stripes we're healed. He was stricken and smitten of God, a man of sorrow, acquainted with grief. Isaiah prophesies it from beginning to the end, and in 24, he really tells us that the earth is going to go through a traumatic event, and we got to be ready.
That's great.
And 26 is great.
Yeah. Oh, Isaiah from front to back is just fascinating. One of these days, we're going to have to write a book just on Isaiah.
Oh, hey, wait a minute. Why don't you get my DVD?
The research. Yes.
Yeah, everybody ordered the DVD.
Get the DVD.
Because this is great revelation there.
I really love it.
You really want it. You really want that. Do Isaiah's prophetic words mirror those of Jesus in Matthew 24, do you think?
It does, because of the traumatic events. I mean, he wanted everyone to know in the prophecy that we would be going through, as Sharon said, birthing pains, that the world was going to get into that last trimester before the end, and it'd be something we didn't thought we'd ever see. Even I thought about it, when Christ first came, no one really could really believe that, am I living in the era of the Messiah? This can't be, right? He's the son of a carpenter. Today, people are like, are you saying this is the last days? Can't be. You know, my grandmother said that. I've been hearing about that all my life. Mm-hmm. And we think in small, very small sections of time. But the Lord told me, Jim, 2 weeks ago, he gave me a word. He said, Paul, I want you to quit focusing on the timeline and focus on the sign line. Because just follow the sign. It'll lead you to the end of the time, the coming of the Lord. So Matthew 24, I believe, is Jesus's roadmap, the entire roadmap to his coming. It's right there.
Boy, we've been preaching that, haven't we, Mondo?
Absolutely. For over 23 years, again, when you came out of prison and we would go to hear you speak and you got invitations, you preached about this. Mm-hmm. You talked about Matthew 24. Mm-hmm. You talked about how the church needs to get ready and prepared. You were like a man crying out in the wilderness, and no one at that moment was hearing what we're teaching
Nobody wanted it. We had pastors would tell us when we would go, and this is before we started television, but we would go out and preach all around, and people, the pastors would say, we know what you're saying, Jim, and, you know, probably you're going to, you know, mellow out a little bit, but we really just want your testimony. And, you know, Jim and I, graciously, we get up and give our testimonies, which is great. Nothing wrong with that. It's wonderful to give your testimony, what God has done. But he had burning inside of him, Matthew 24.
Yes, he did.
And has continued. And he hasn't mellowed out. He's gotten stronger.
Amen.
And now he brings in people like you. Pastor Paul, who is like, come on.
Well, you know, Jesus said we'd experience these extreme events happening all at once.
Yeah.
We are seeing major drought in the West right now.
Oh, wow. It's amazing
We're seeing fires like, my God.
Yeah.
The West is on fire.
It really is.
Really praying.
And we're seeing earthquakes. We're seeing all the other things happening. But let me roll this report, and then we're going to comment on it. We'll be right back.
In California, the horrific sound of a firestorm and the gut-wrenching sight of homes consumed by flames from a massive fire north of Lake Tahoe. And this, a fire tornado fueled by intense heat and powerful winds. It sparks memories of 2020, the worst year ever for California wildfires. This year, twice as many acres have already burned. The largest so far is this fire in Northern California, three times the size of San Francisco. Erratic winds proving dangerous for firefighters. In Oregon, the nation's biggest fire is continuing to grow exponentially.
We are seeing, doubling in size of the fire every 24 hours.
And that wildfire near the state's southern border has affected power lines, now threatening the electric grid in parts of Oregon and California. Making conditions worse, unrelenting heat, weeks of record-breaking temperatures throughout the West. Las Vegas tying its all-time record of 117 degrees. The hottest it's ever been in Grand Junction, Colorado, 107. In Death Valley, 130, just 4 degrees shy of the hottest ever recorded on Earth. And new concerns tonight about a wildfire near Yosemite National Park.
Ashes were falling just everywhere.
We had a beautiful house, might be all gone, and what do? You start over, so we don't know.
These, simply put, are the worst possible conditions for firefighters. Temperatures are well above 100 degrees. There's no rain. And tonight, there are hundreds of residents in the same position as the Gordons. They just don't know whether their homes have burned to the ground.
Paul, we've had hurricanes on the East Coast and drought and fires on the West Coast all at the same time. Is this one of the ways we know we're in the last days?
Absolutely, Jim. You know, and then while it's so hot in the West and the dryness and the fires, east of the Mississippi, floods.
Right.
Detroit, Kansas City, all the way across the East. Sinkholes are opening up everywhere. And so we're watching these combination of things, mm-hmm. which would really, you know, it's not like, well, they had a volcano over here. Well, that happened, you know, in Mount Etna, whatever. No, they're all, we broke records the last 4 years in earthquakes. We've broke records every year the last 3 years in volcanoes. Mm-hmm. We have extreme weather conditions, heat to sub temperatures, unbelievable. So all of it is combining. Asteroids are racing by. This is it. We're in the final phase. I think we've turned the corner. We're on a stretch run right now, and it's time that people give their life to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And get born again. Because it's a combination of things. It's all of them at once. Mm-hmm. I was on a Christian network one day, and they asked me, said, do you think we're in the last days? And I said, think? I know.
Yeah.
The urgency is in the emergency room, okay? Mm. And America and the world has come to this point where it's time that we got to get back to the altar.
Yeah. You know?
We just got to get back to the altar.
That's
again.
That's so good.
Yeah.
There's such healing at the altar.
Amen.
The first several verses of Isaiah 24 tells us of the earth wobbling to and fro. Have we seen this type of action on earth recently, do you know?
Yes, the poles are shifting as we speak. I mean, the due north is in Siberia right now. Yeah. And while that's happening, I just seen yesterday, there's a wobble on Mars, which is going to drastically affect the weather on earth. So not only is the earth shaking, Jesus said, Luke 21, he said, for there shall be signs in the sun, the moon, the stars, and distress of nations with perplexity. The sea, the waves will be roaring, and men's hearts will fail them for fear, for things come on the earth. For the powers of heaven shall be shaken. Mm. Shaken. So that means even the space itself, everything up there. So I was a little bit worried the other day when Richard Branson went up there. I thought, you know, he might have had one joy ride, but I got a ride coming pretty soon, folks. I'm seriously. It's not going to cost me $250,000 either to do it.
But here the good news is that there is an awakening beginning.
That's right.
The Lord is preaching. The Holy Spirit is working. And you're experiencing that down in Florida.
Oh, down in Florida, Jim? Oh, my. Okay, so there's a church down there called Freedom Fellowship, down in the Villages.
Okay.
You've ever been to the Villages?
Sure.
And we started going there high night because I went down there for treatments for the stroke.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Well, there's a church there. They said, come on over. We started helping the pastor, Melvin Whittington, a wonderful pastor. That church has grown from 70 to 270 since March.
That's awesome.
The building was too small, so I said, why don't we pitch a tent? He went out and bought a tent that seats 1,000 people. They are coming from everywhere. Wow. They're driving in from everywhere.
Amazing.
It's like God is, there's an outpouring. And I don't think it's just one spot. It's going to happen here. No, it's already happening here in the, right here in Branson in this area.
Mm-hmm.
But there's an outpouring, a last day harvest. Yes. The world needs Christ. This network needs you. Yes. And Jesus is coming soon. We got to get him in.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Got to get him in.
Paul and Derek. The pole shifting is something that is near the end of times.
Yes.
When the plates and all are going to shift and all this shifting, and it says everything, every island is going to be moved out of its
place. That's right.
we're nearing that time, people. We're seeing these things begin to happen. Mm-hmm. And this, you know, the fact that you guys dare preach this is scaring me.
What? Are you serious?
I'm serious. Because this is what I learned in the Bible when I was in the prison, and I studied, and I learned what would be the signs. And I'll tell you, I saw the future. Mm. And I know what's coming. Mm. And we're in the midst of the end times. All these things, the falling away of America, the falling away, people backsliding, people cold. Oh. The America, the United States was a land of God.
Yep.
It's a land of Satan almost now. I mean, we've turned our back on God in this country.
And the Bible says,
Sharon,
that the mothers will be turned against the daughters, the sons against
true.
The fathers.
The fathers.
What are we seeing right now? There is a plan in place where children are being told, here's how you can help inform on your friends and your family.
Unbelievable.
Doesn't that just chill you?
Yes, absolutely.
That's the kind of thing that we only thought we would ever hear about from the Soviet Union or East Germany, but now is happening here. Just this past week, the FBI issued a statement asking people to inform on their friends and their relatives because they might be radicalized. Here are the signs to look for, and if you see something, call us and say something.
And it's after Christians are the scariest element in our country.
Mm. Yes, the most dangerous threat to American security.
Praise God, we are considered scary.
Amen.
Are they talking about you, Sharon?
Look, the Lord is trying to work. And sometimes we just get in the way.
Yeah.
And I love it. Derek, who I dreamed many, many years ago he was going to be a preacher, and he is. He told me, no, that's not going to happen. But you know what?
I'm a radio guy. I don't know how to be a preacher.
The most inspired, and I mean that word when I say it, things that you say when you are speaking, it's when you get out of the way. You explain. You can explain it better than I can.
There are times when I things come out of my mouth that were not planned. Mm-hmm. That when I watch a video later, it's like, wow, I don't remember saying that. I literally don't remember saying that.
Yeah.
It's happened to me a few times. Mm-hmm. And usually when it's important, but it's also because I just pray whenever I speak, just, mm-hmm. Lord, just take me out of the way because I mess things up. I try to show off, you know, how smart I am, which is a thing from when I was, you know, a kid in school and I was the smartest kid in the kindergarten. That sort of sticks with you. But
I never had that problem, Derek. I've never
had. But it can be a curse because it gets in the way. You think that you're the smartest one in the room, and that prevents the wisdom of the Holy Spirit from getting through. So it's when you get yourself out of the way that the Holy Spirit can actually speak and minister. Amen. And that's when I tend to get really, really emotional.
Oh, I love watching you when you get all emotional. It's good.
Paul, you said that in this teaching that Isaiah 24 is also similar to Revelation's description in the heavens, such as wormwood and all that. Would you explain all that?
Absolutely. In Revelation chapter 8, Jim, the Bible says that there's going to be two deep impacts. It's going to hit the earth. And I really agree with Tom Horn, and he's got a great book called The Wormwood Prophecy, I think.
Great book.
Great book. And the Bible says there's going to be a deep impact that hits the water, or hits the ocean, mm-hmm. wipes out a third of the ships and a third of the creatures. And then a second one, like a star called wormwood, hits apparently land, brings a lot of radiation because it turns the water bitter, you know, wormwood. And many men die. Now, we have, as we speak, asteroids coming this way. They say by the year 2005, we're going to go through an asteroid. It's not just a belt. It's a unbelievable 2 million miles wide, several years deep of incoming near-Earth objects. This is before Apophis gets here in 2029. So the Earth is going to go through some impacts. This is, and I believe, before Jesus comes. Okay? We're going to experience mountains moving, as you said, islands moving, and impacts that's going to hit the earth. But no fear. We don't have the spirit of fear. We just got to understand who's in charge.
Amen.
You know?
Amen. That's God.
How soon can these things begin to happen, do you think?
In the next 3 to 5 years. I would say we may see Revelation 8 by the year 2025.
Oh,
it's
yeah.
very possible.
Would you agree? I so agree with you.
Thank you.
And let me tell you, our children are being trained. They're being programmed to look at all these things happening. They're going to go, oh, climate change.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
It's climate change.
Right.
It's climate change, which means that we have to do everything we're told to fix the climate.
Because they're saying we're the ones that cause it.
Yes.
Right. But what they're missing, and this is where the church also needs to do a better job, is understand that this is also a spiritual event. These yes, events yes. in Revelation 8,
right.
and we argued this in the book,
Giants,
forthcoming,
Concentra-
no,
oh,
Zeitgeist 2025,
yeah.
I think.
Oh, yeah, yeah. We wrote for that, too.
So Tom's forthcoming book pointed out that in the Old Testament period, the word star often refers to an angel. But also, get this, the second trumpet, the great mountain burning with fire, mm-hmm. one of the main nicknames of the chief god of Mesopotamia, Enlil, was Great Mountain. In fact, his temple was the Ikur, the house of the mountain, or the mountain house. The Book of Enoch, which we've talked about on the program before, which is not in the Bible, but it helps us understand some of the strange parts of the Bible. When Enoch is taken to the underworld, he's shown seven burning mountains, and he's told these are angels who disobeyed. That's where they were punished in Netherworld.
That's right.
So we're looking at, yes, a spiritual, a physical event.
Yes.
I agree.
Yep.
But we also need to remember this is God, under God's control. It is a supernatural event.
That's right.
Amen.
So we've got multiple facets to this. But that should make us as Christians rejoice because that means this is all under God's control. When you start talking about it in that language, hey, this is our language. We should control this. We've got, as our friend L.A. Marzulli calls it, the guidebook to the supernatural.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
And most churches
Amen.
Don't
That's
teach
right.
it.
That's right.
And you know, Jim, I've noticed, and you can read through the whole Bible. I did a series one time called The Prophetic Earthquakes of the Bible. Whatever's going on in the spiritual world manifests as in the physical.
Yes.
Constantly.
Yes, absolutely.
Whether it's like when Jesus rose from the dead, the Bible says one angel came and rolled the stone away. But that one angel also opened the graves of many saints that walked around, not just Jesus. Do you know when it says he returns, that he's bringing all the angels with him? So what kind of a ruckus are they going to create when they when they come? They're going to open all the graves. And I'm ready. I'm ready.
I believe with all my heart that we are in the final days. Mm-hmm. We're there. Mm-hmm. I realized that we were entering this age of the four horses, and yet now these horses are riding. Mm-hmm. I believe COVID is part of it. What do you think?
Oh, I so agree with you. And we've talked about this before, that that fourth rider is given a name. He's called Death, but it's actually Thanatos. That's the name of a Greek god. It's one of the gods that takes you to the underworld, and he rides with somebody else. Hades is there with him, and he's using Therion as his weapon. It means little beast. In other words, it's viruses and bacteria, as well as big beasts like lions and tigers and bears. Oh, my.
Yeah.
In fact, you know, in China, there are elephants. They've escaped from, it's a whole elephant herd that's just been running all through the country. So we've got beasts on the loose, a lot of animals that
That's
didn't
right.
get fed because the zoos shut down during COVID, who didn't get tourists coming and throwing them food because there were no tourists during COVID. So a lot of things have affected our animal population, but these little beasts, these viruses and bacteria, they are coming after us with all powers of the fallen realm. But God's allowing it.
It's like hell.
It's like hell on earth because it is. These writers, well, we get it. Tom Horn came to me and asked me, because I wrote a book called Ebola and the Fourth Horseman. And he asked me if I would update that and write it about, you know, COVID. And I said, well, yeah, I can. And started looking at it and I prayed about it. And I talked to Derek and I said, you know, I really feel like if we're going to talk about that fourth writer, we need to talk about the other three. So that's why we wrote Giants, Gods, and Dragons. It turned into that book, and we actually dug in, and we think we've identified the other three.
Wow.
Do you all believe the four horsemen of the apocalypse are riding?
Yes.
Absolutely.
You believe that?
Absolutely.
I have four people here, innocent bystanders. And they agree with me.
How many of you think they're writing?
All right, got a bunch of them.
And this is a big sign of the last days.
Yeah.
It's so big that most people, theologians, a lot of them just choke almost trying to admit it, but they know it's true. And we're living in these final days.
Oh, but there's
a lot of people are going to have to adjust their theology by what's going on in the world right now.
Yes, because there are some churches that teach, you know, it's just going to get better and better.
Better and better.
And better.
Mm. It ain't going to get better.
No.
I've read the book. It gets better in heaven, I'll tell you that.
Yeah. That's right. But,
and that's where we're going to have joy forever.
The early church fathers understood that these entities that John wrote about in the Revelation, that Isaiah writes about, chapter 24, when you read the host of heaven in heaven, on that day, which is the day of the Lord, when he pours out his wrath on an unrepentant world, on that day, the Lord will punish the host of heaven in heaven and the kings of the earth on earth. Who's the host of heaven? He's not talking about stars and comets and asteroids.
No.
He's talking about the heavenly host, the heavenly army. Deuteronomy 4:19, those are the gods of the pagan world, those that God allotted to all the nations as their gods. A day is coming when these gods, small g gods, will die.
Right. Yep.
That has been decreed. And you see it multiple times in the Old Testament, but right here in Isaiah 24.
Isaiah 24.
Psalm 82, you will die like men.
When I was 19 years old, one of the great prophets, Helverson, prophesied that I would help usher in the coming of the Lord.
Wow.
Now, he said it. I didn't say it.
Wow.
And I believe God has let me live to warn you. He let me go through prison to experience the other. I have dreams that if I wrote a book about them, I don't know if it'd either be a great seller or it would be no one would buy it because it's so awful.
Tom Horn would publish it.
Yeah, he would. Oh, my.
It's awful.
Isn't that the truth?
I wanted you to sing a song, Pastor Begley. Do you have a short one that we could do before we go off the air today? I wanted to do a song, because tomorrow we'll start in with part two of this conversation. Mm-hmm.
Let's do it.
But the king is coming back. I know that,
yes,
people.
Yes, he is.
Phillips, the two DVD set, and then the bonus CD of the music. Mm-hmm. So you get all of that for a gift of what?
$30.
Just $30.
Just $30. But we also do have a three-pack, so you can order the Isaiah's Apocalypse three-pack offer for a $60 donation, which includes shipping and handling. So you're going to receive the three DVD set plus a bonus CDs, and that's all for just a donation of $60 to the ministry.
Well, I hope everybody has ordered my book this week.
Yes.
And they, people are telling me it's an amazing read. And so I hope you'll get it and read it. And your $30 is going to help us to stay on the air, to pay our bills and all. So order my book today, and you can make it.
Amen. Yes, you can.
Amen.
Our time's gone.
She's
for today.
Right here.
Paul will be back with us tomorrow, along with Derek and Sharon Gilbert. So don't miss tomorrow's broadcast. We do have to go. Call us right now. What's the number, Lori?
Just call us at 1-888-988-1588 or go to the website, jimbakershow.com.
God loves you. He really does. Bye-bye for today.
Bye-bye. We love you.
Paul Begley, Derek, and Sharon Gilbert for being with us.